Firebase gives us an entire authentication system for free that we can use on our Firebase application or as a standalone if we have a backend somewhere else. The authentication system handles almost everything you need in terms of user authentication, password encryption, and different methods of authentication. To see what we can do with the authentication system, you're going to go into your Firebase console and you click on the authentication button in the navigation bar. There you're going to see a list of your users and the sign-in methods. When you click on sign-in methods, you see all of the authentication providers you have available with Firebase. With that out of the way, let's talk about the different things we can do to secure our authentication system. First, let's talk about authorized domains. For security reasons, to be able to use phone number, social, or third-party authentication, all of the ones that require redirect or pop-ups, the domains you'll use need to be authorized. So one of the things we should do before deploying our app is ensuring that only the domain we are going to use is in the authorized domain list. For that, you are going to look here, and when it says authorized domains, first you need to remove localhost. That way we avoid someone running your application in development and being able to do it. And then you're going to click add domain, and you're going to add the domain for your page. For example, let's say this is going to be jsmobiledev.com. These two domains you have here, they are for your application. These are the default domains that Firebase gives you. We just added our domain as an authorized domain to perform auth operations. But what about something like email authentication? An attacker with enough experience could load your application and use Chrome Dev Tools to find your Firebase credentials, use them in their project locally, and add users to your Firebase application. And depending on your database security rules, they will even write or read information to your database. There's no need to panic. You can also lock your API key too, and that way it can only be used from your domain. And for that, we are going to open a new tab and we are going to navigate to the GCP console. That's console.cloud.google.com. Once the page loads, you're going to click on Select a Project and you're going to find your Firebase project. Then, in the navigation bar, you're going to find API and Services and you're going to click on Credentials. You're going to see that here we have in the API keys, we have a browser key auto-generated by Firebase. And if you look at that key, it starts with AIZA. If you go back to your Firebase application and go into the project settings, you're going to see that that's the same API key we get from the credentials. Now, when you click the Edit API Key icon, you're going to be taken to the detail page of this specific API key. So first, let's understand what application restrictions are. They are restrictions that we put on our API key saying, okay, you will only work in this application. For example, we can lock our API key so that it only does a query to Firebase from our domain. Or if you're using a native application, we can lock it so that it only receives queries from that application's specific package. That way, if I get your credentials and load them into my environment, I will get an error whenever I try to access one of your Firebase services. To restrict our API to be used only for a certain domain, we're going to go down to Application Restrictions here, and we're going to select the option HTTP Referrers, Websites. Once you do that, a new space will open in the app, and you'll see the button that says Add Item. Click it and add your domain name there. So for example, here in the referrer, I'm going to use example.com. I click Done. Let's take a moment here to save our changes. It says it should take around 5 minutes to propagate your changes. Once the changes are propagated, you can test this by going into your application. And in the code, you can try making any type of call to Firebase. So for example, here, if after we initialize our application, we do something like firebase.auth.createUser with email and password, like we are just going to create a new user, we are sending the email, we are sending a random password, and we click save. You'll notice that when it tries to post this to Firebase, it's getting a 403 error. You see? And it says, here's the message, auth internal error, it's 403, requests from this domain are blocked. Now let's go back to edit our application key. And here you need to be careful about how you add domains. For example, there are three use cases that we should account for. First, we want to give access to all of the routes around domain to have access to Firebase. We do that by adding our domain and our domain with a wildcard like this. For example, if I do HTTPS, this would be, let me make this a little bigger. This would be my domain, and I could be able to add my domain here. But if I want all of the pages on my website to be able to access my API key, then I need to add a wildcard, and it will be like this, my domain slash and the star. This will say, okay, everything behind jsmobiledev.com is allowed here. If you are also serving unprotected content without an SSL certificate, which you shouldn't, you also need to add it here. So for this use case, you would do the same. It would be http jsmobiledev.com, and then again you go and type http jsmobiledev.com slash the star. This is going to say, okay, both HTTPS and HTTP calls for my domain are allowed. Second, if you don't have a redirect for when the user types www and make it look like this, then you are going to also need to add your domain here, but with the www in the beginning. And it's the same thing, www and then the one with the star. You see how the list of domains starts populating here? So here I will recommend two things. First, always, always, always serve your content, serve your application through HTTPS. That way you can remove those two here. And also you can do with your domain provider, you can create a redirect and make sure that every time someone types www.yourdomain.com, that they are redirected to your domain without the www. That way this also can go away. The second use case we need to account for is when we have a subdomain. So for example, let's say here I'm also serving an admin application. So it would be something like this. And same, if I want this, I'll add it. And then if I want to add all of the routes behind that subdomain, I also need to add the wildcard. And the third use case would be, okay, but what if I don't have one subdomain? What if I have many? For example, let's say you have an application that uses different tenants and each of them have their subdomain. For that, we can actually delete those and we can use also wildcards. So for example, I want to say, okay, any subdomain of jsmobiledev.com can be allowed. Or I want to say any subdomain can be allowed, but also any route inside of that subdomain can be allowed. And you see, in the end, it would look something like this. These four rules right here are telling you anything behind, like any route at jsmobiledev.com has access, and any subdomain of jsmobiledev.com has access. After you're done setting up your application restrictions, it's also a very good idea to set your API restrictions. API restrictions tell Firebase which Google APIs your API can access. It's a good idea because if your API is compromised and someone manages to spoof a request from your domain, then we have an extra layer of security that says, okay, this API key can only access Firebase authentication and Firestore, nothing else. For that, you're going to navigate below website restrictions, and when you find API restrictions, you're going to say restrict key. And in here, you can select the APIs you want to give access to. So for example, here we're going to find, there's nothing for auth, fire. Okay, here we have Firestore, say Firebase hosting, what else? Firebase rules API. We're not going to use app distribution, cloud messaging. So yeah, we are only going to give those three rules. That way, if something happens to our application and the key gets compromised, they can only access these three portions of the Google Cloud Console. This will work for more than authentication. You are also locking file store access and more. So make sure that you do this for your production application. But before you do it, you have to set up the Firebase emulator so that you can develop your app locally unrestricted, because ideally, then localhost won't be able to access your application.